At Concord Eastside Elementary, the students have been working hard to make it to the day that they've been looking forward to since they were in kindergarten, Weather Balloon Launch Day.
Today, we launched a weather balloon, and we're very excited about that because it's kind of the culmination of about 4 months worth of work on the students' part.
We have been working on this for quite a while since we have launched the last one. This was our second weather balloon, and how it kind of works is we have some stretchy tape where we have to fill the weather balloon up with helium, and then we quickly turn it off and slowly close it with our hands, tightly grip it, and then we put some tape around it, peel the helium tube off, and then we usually put a rope around it that attaches to the GoPro and the beeper, and then we let it go, and we have experiments on it. We have silly putty and some other slime experiments, and we put them on there, and then once it comes back from near space, we will see what happened to the experiments and what if they changed or not.
It felt really exciting and nerve-wracking because, I mean, anything could happen. But I'm proud because we launched a weather balloon, and most meteorologists work for 20 years and they don't get to launch a weather balloon.
With the help of technology, students are able to track their weather balloon.
So the balloon is traveling. It's headed east right now, we know that for sure. And as soon as we're all finished out here, we are gonna head inside and we're going to figure out where the balloon is headed exactly, and we'll come up with a plan. And then we're gonna load 14 kids on 2 activity buses and we're gonna chase the balloon as it's flying. The balloon will reach about 100,000 feet in altitude before it pops, and then it'll come down back to Earth, hopefully in a really easy to access location, and then we will go pick it up today.
We ran predictions and it's landing close to Lake Erie, so we don't want that. Hopefully it doesn't land. As long as it lands on land and not in water, it's good.
I am hoping the balloon will land in Ohio.
Well, we're just hoping it doesn't land in water. To the east of us, there are a number of Great Lakes, and we predict that it will land in eastern Michigan, but there's kind of a big unknown because we don't really know what's going on in the upper atmosphere, so the winds could be quite a bit different than we're expecting.
Getting to see their project come to life makes all the hard work worthwhile.
Well, the kids definitely learned some great science skills. Obviously, there's some significant mathematical calculations involved to figure out where the balloon's headed and how quickly it's going to rise once we let go of it. And then some other really great things they learn are communication. The kids wrote to local businesses to get our t-shirts donated and the helium we needed donated. They had to call the FAA and let them know that we're doing this, so they let pilots know to be on the lookout for this balloon. They learned collaboration. They have to work together to make all this happen. Not one of us could not do this project, or it's not possible for one person to do what we did today. They learn critical thinking. The kids send experiments up with the balloon so that we could test the effects of the upper atmosphere on different materials. And they learn just a lot of creativity. I mean, some of the problem solving we had to do here was just very unique to this project and very unique to a real science experiment. So it definitely was an opportunity for them to practice those skills.
I was kind of nervous and excited. Why I was nervous was because someone almost dropped the balloon and it almost hit someone's head, which would weaken the balloon. And I am excited because I get to skip a whole day of school and I get to go traveling on a bus.
It is definitely a once-in-a-lifetime experience for the kids, and as a teacher, it's just an unbelievable thing to see kids working together and see them really applying what they've learned in a real way to make this happen. And it's just, I'm excited for their futures as well, because this is a project that a lot of adults will never get to see or do themselves. And if they're 10 and 11 years old and doing it now, it's amazing to think what they're gonna do in the future.